Blackstone Audio presents My Utmost, a Devotional Memoir by Macy Halford. This book is read by Karen White. For my mother and my grandmother. 1. A river touches places of which its source knows nothing. September 6th. Dallas, 2011. The slender blue book had been lying on my bedside table for years before I started reading it, ever since the night of my baptism, when my grandmother had presented it to me as a gift, a sort of token of my entry into religious maturity. I'd tried to read it then, but hadn't gotten very far. At 13, I was a keen enough reader, and My Utmost for His Highest was an inviting book, a daily devotional, with a brief reading for each day of the year. But at the start, it suffered unfairly from its association with a senior citizen. After one sentence, I'd decided it was old-fashioned, as fusty and tedious as everything else my grandmother liked, the book equivalent of boiled vegetables, potted pansies, needlepoint, PBS, Chanel No. 5, and the taupe-colored Chevy she'd been driving for 20 years. All of these things bored me. I think they even bored my grandmother. If she liked them, it was because they were set to her frequency. Once, when I asked her why she never talked about her life, or anything really beyond the weather, she offered this as an explanation. The Macys are a very boring people. Macy being her maiden name and the source of my own. I replied that I hoped she wasn't including me in her assessment, and she smiled and said, "Oh no, Macy dear, you are always fascinating." It is tempting to read into this statement a slyness or even a bite, but my grandmother's was not a mind given to doubleness. On the rare occasions when she spoke of her own parents and grandparents, who had all lived out their lives back on the farm, she used the expression salt of the earth without irony. But I shouldn't employ the past tense when I talk about my grandmother. She is still alive. It is merely her mind, or much of it anyway, that belongs to the past, having begun its final flight several years ago, around her 86th birthday. Otherwise, she is well and still going about her daily rounds as she always has, in the little red brick house on Wabash Avenue in Dallas, Texas, where in the 1980s and 90s she helped my mother to raise me and my brother and my sister, and which I left to go north to New York just after my 18th birthday. It was a recent visit to this house and my grandmother that prompted me to begin thinking about Utmost, or rather to begin thinking about it in a different way than I usually did. At that point, I'd been reading the book more or less every day for 15 years, and so I thought about it often. Or maybe it makes more sense to say that I thought with it, since its presence in my life had become so fixed that I hardly noticed it was there anymore. It wasn't until this visit, when I happened to spot my grandmother's own ancient copy on the kitchen countertop, where we were sitting drinking coffee, that I began to wonder about the fact that we'd both been reading it so long, she even longer than I, and even after losing her mind. "Do you still read this book, Nana?" I asked, and after I'd repeated the question, she confirmed that she did. "Every morning when I wake up, bright and early," she said, "6 a.m., that's when I'm up. Early to bed, early to rise, makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise." It was my grandmother's short-term memory that had disappeared, not her long, or, alas, the bit where her vast collection of moralizing aphorisms was stored. "Also a woman," I replied. "Just look at you, 90 years old and still going strong." To which she shook her head in confusion, having apparently forgotten her previous statement. How, I wondered, could a person who couldn't recall what she'd just said still enjoy reading? Wouldn't she have forgotten one sentence by the time she reached the next? My grandmother took a sip of her coffee, then abruptly turned and left the kitchen. She'd gotten into the habit.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.